I am fascinated with YouTube as a whole, from just the platform itself, to the algorithm, to being able to interact with people all the way across the globe. I absolutely love it. And YouTube is always changing and always will be changing. I mean, look at YouTube from where it started to how it is now. It is completely different, at least visually different, and there are many changes that have gone through the system. And on November 10th, YouTube said that they're going to start gradually removing the dislike count from videos. Before, you used to be able to see how many dislikes there are. Eventually, you won't be able to. So in this video, I just want to talk about what YouTube actually had to say about these changes. What does it mean for the viewers and the creators, and what my opinion is on all of this. So here's what YouTube had to say, and this is from the YouTube, the official YouTube blog. So YouTube said they're making the dislike count private across YouTube, but the dislike button is not going to go away. So a little while ago, YouTube experimented by removing the dislike count from some videos to see if it resulted in less dislike attacks and dislike harassment on videos. And of course, it did result in less dislikes on videos, which makes sense because people like to follow the crowd. If a lot of people are disliking a video, more people are also likely to dislike that video. What was really interesting to me was that small creators said that they are unfairly targeted by dislike attacks and also like dislike harassment. And YouTube actually found this out to be true, that smaller channels were at a higher proportion of dislike attacks and dislike harassment than larger channels. Which, I totally believe that, because, you know, people like to pick on the little guy. If there's a bully picking on a little guy, people are gonna go with the big bully and not support the small guy, the small creator, like myself. Not saying that I'm a victim of this, but I can just sympathize from being a small creator myself. So based off all this information they gathered from their experiments, whatever experiments they did, that's kind of a weird way to put it, I guess I would say like research, YouTube decided they're going to make the dislike count private on videos. They stated that they know some people might not like the change, but they believe it is the right direction to take. AKA, they're gonna do it anyway, even if people get mad. So what does this really mean? So anyone can still dislike videos, the dislike button's still gonna be there, you just won't be able to see how many dislikes are on the video. I just checked on YouTube, on my computer, and also on my phone. The numbers are still there, so they did say they're gonna gradually get rid of this. Who knows what's gonna go first, if it's gonna be on computer. I know on my smart TV, I already can't see the dislike count, so who knows how long it's gonna take for them to actually get rid of the dislike count, but they said they're going to. So viewers can still use the dislike button to privately tell the creator they don't like the video, and the creator can still see the number of dislikes. It's just no longer public information. Another thing YouTube stated was that you can still use the dislike button to help dictate your recommendations. If you dislike a video, you're less likely to be recommended more videos of that same style or same type of video. It's a good thing they mentioned that, because I didn't even think about that with recommendations. This is getting really dark. So the idea behind this is to hopefully help reduce dislike attacks and dislike mobs, which is a good thing. I don't really like how some creators can just get really targeted by a lot of dislikes and a lot of harassment through dislikes. But also on the other side, there are some people who kind of deserve to get a lot of dislikes on their videos. If someone's being a genuine, just bad human being, they deserve to see that people don't like the video, and everyone else should also be able to see that a lot of people don't like that video as well, not just the creator. I just feel that some people do deserve some harsh criticism if you're just being a genuine bad person. So I wanted to ask you guys about this, and I put a poll on my YouTube channel to see what you guys thought about this. As for the results, there was 105 votes, which was kind of low. I guess you guys probably just didn't really care about it that much, but out of 105 votes, 23 people said they didn't really care about it. Only 6 people said they're glad it's gone. 59 people said that they really want it back, and 17 people didn't even know that the change was happening. Which I get, like, it's not like they're putting it on the front page of YouTube, like, hey, we're getting rid of this. They're not hiding it either, but it's not just like blatantly out there. So overall, it seems like you guys do want to be able to see the dislike count. I think a few of you didn't really understand what that meant. I think you guys thought that the dislikes were just going away as a whole. So as for myself, I rarely dislike videos. Like, I almost hardly ever hit the dislike button on a video. The only time I dislike a video is if someone is like actually harassing like a person or a group of people, or if they're just like genuinely being a bad person. Like, there's some people out there who are like really, for lack of a better word, just like shitty people on the internet. And those people deserve to get disliked. So if I just don't like a video, I don't touch the like button or the dislike button. So just having less interactions on the video, that creator is then less likely to have that video recommended to others, and it's just, that's how the algorithm works. So if I just generally don't like the video, I won't do anything, I won't interact at all, and I just won't watch the video anymore. So one thing that I don't like is that, specifically for tutorial style videos, if the tutorial has a lot of dislikes, it's obviously not a very well done video. Being able to see that number of dislikes is gonna dictate if I wanna watch it or not. And without that information, who knows if it's a good tutorial. But even then, if it's a bad tutorial, not many people are going to watch it, and it's less likely to be recommended to you or at the top of your searches. I do think it's a good thing for small creators, because I do feel that we can get targeted by dislike mobs pretty easily. Like I said before, when you're the small guy, people are likely just to kind of like punch you down, and more people are gonna join to that crowd. And if someone's disliking a video, more and more people are going to dislike it just because you're small and you might not have that much experience on YouTube. Like, someone who is less experienced isn't going to have as high of a quality of video. And some people are just going to dislike the video because it's not at a high quality. Other people are going to see those dislikes and also dislike it for lesser quality. And it's just kind of like a snowball effect going downhill with all of these dislikes. And that's very discouraging when you're a small creator. Getting a lot of dislikes, it makes you not want to make any more videos. So maybe this will give smaller creators a better chance at making it big on YouTube. Or at least, at the very minimum, it's going to discourage these dislike attacks and give small creators less stress when making videos. For larger channels, I really don't think that this is going to affect them whatsoever. If you're a larger YouTuber, you obviously make videos that people like, so you've already made it. Your regular viewers are gonna continue liking your videos, and you're probably gonna get the same number of dislikes on your videos just from those random lesser amount of people that dislike your videos. I also don't like that we can no longer see if other people are disliking some shitty humans' content on the internet. If someone is just being a genuinely bad person on the internet, they deserve to get dislikes, and now we won't be able to see that information, which sucks. Another thing that I'm going to miss about it is that we won't be able to see the like to dislike ratio as well. Like, if a video is really good, we won't be able to see, like, oh, this thing got 100,000 likes and only 2,000 dislikes. Like, that's a really good video. Now that information's just kind of lost and gone. We only get to see the number of likes, not the dislikes. So overall, I think this is probably just gonna be like the whole subscriber count abbreviation thing from a few years ago. So remember how like 2 years ago, YouTube decided they were just gonna abbreviate the number of subscribers on people's channels? Before, you used to be able to see the exact number of subscribers, now it's just like 7.68K. People were pissed about that for a little while, and then it kind of just fizzled out, people forgot about it, and now no one really cares. And most people actually think it's a good thing that you don't see the exact number of subscribers anymore. I feel like this is going to be probably the same sort of situation. And like I said before, YouTube is gonna make the change regardless of what people say about it. Okay, so that's it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any input, please let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear about it. Please dislike this video if you didn't like it, because eventually no one's gonna see it. But like it if you did enjoy this video, because it really does help me. Otherwise, subscribe if you wanna see more of this content, and thank you guys for watching my video. Peace out.